Hello and welcome to the Vegan Corner. Being Italians, we love pasta. You probably already know this by now though, seeing as this is the third pasta dish we have uploaded. But this recipe also happens to be one of our all-time favorites, spaghetti alla carbonara. As pasta lovers, we believe that it doesn't matter what shape, size or color your pasta is, so long as it tastes good. If you are a pasta lover yourself, keep watching and I'm sure you'll be glued to the screen. The ingredients are listed in the description below the video. Let's start by replacing the pancetta with some courgettes, or zucchini, depending on where in the world you live. Although it might look like an odd substitution, I can guarantee you that it really does work. I even used to make carbonara with zucchini before I was vegan. Cut the courgettes into slabs, then into strips. Now dice the strips, and that's the hard part of the recipe done. Now to the sauce. Start by placing the carrots, the miso, the paprika, the onion and garlic granules, flour, salt, nutritional yeast, and the milk into a container. Blitz the ingredient with a stick blender until you obtain a smooth and lump-free sauce, which will be the base of the final condiment. Now take your favorite pan, place it over medium heat, and dip in the zucchini. Time to cook the diced courgettes. Do this for roughly 10-15 minutes or until they become slightly golden brown. This will require you to stir every now and then to avoid burning the vegetables and also to allow for the zucchini to brown uniformly. Once finished, set the courgettes aside for a later use. You can do all of this in advance and then cook the pasta according to the instruction on the packet. Place the pan back over a medium heat, add in the sauce and throw in the cooked pasta. Stir well until the sauce becomes incredibly creamy and delicious looking. Then mix in the cooked zucchini to complete the dish. The last two things I'd like to mention here are to remember that tasting the pasta and adding salt if you feel it is needed is definitely the way forward. Secondly, carbonara cannot be called carbonara without a reasonable quantity of black pepper on it, so make sure to add it to the dish before serving it. And here you have the final dish. I'm not sure if there is anything else to add here. I mean, look at that dish, a velvety and succulent spaghetti alla carbonara, ready to be enjoyed, or devoured if you are hungry enough. If you enjoyed this recipe, please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and we'll make sure to upload more Italian-inspired pasta dishes in the future. Thanks for watching and to the next recipe.